Hello everybody, welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit, and this is going to be the weirdest location I think I've ever done a cigar review ever. It's right under in a this little shopette area. Couldn't find any place that wasn't like taken right now. People, that kind of thing. And my main thing is, one, I want to be able to be somewhat uninterrupted, and also, which I really don't care about that, the main part is I don't want to bother anybody. I try to respect the other people around me, and so there we are. Anyway, sorry about that, kind of went around everywhere looking for different spaces, finally, what the hell, pull over here, nobody right over here, kind of at this angle. You're looking up at me, kind of, but that's just going to have to be how it is this time. I'll try to keep at least my head in the camera area. Today we're doing an Arson cigar. I've done one other one, and I think that's the only one that they actually have. This is a Dominican Puro cigar. Let's see if we can see the band. It's called Pink for Men. It's Arson, like I said, 100% Dominican. I know what that taste is. Very interesting. Long time ago, when I was a kid, really, my parents, they had, I think they were like dried dates or figs, one or the other. And I honestly don't know which one it was, because I, like I said, as a kid, I was just looking for something to eat. And not that they didn't feed me, just ended up that way. Anyway, that's this rough draw that I'm getting there, that I'm tasting. That's the flavor that I get. And I know there's a wind, so I'm going to try to stay out of it. Hopefully it's not going to be too bad. But it is kind of windy through here, which it wasn't windy just a little while ago, so I don't know what that's all about. There we go. It's going to worry me. Wow. This might be a rough draw. We'll see. Pretty rough on the draw so far, really kind of burning my tongue a little bit. There's a lot of wind, so that's not going to help. This cigar is a poor performer. Part of it might have to do with the wind, but we'll see. It's very, it's got a bitter taste right at the moment, but it's just right at first. I have a black tea, that's what I'm going to rinse my palate with, I guess, and but we'll see how this is. It is a Robusto size, I do believe. I bought this a few weeks ago, and just because I, honestly, part of it was this band right here. I figured, what the hell, let's get it, see what it's about. Honestly, I went to Arson, I think it's arsoncigars.com. It directs you to another site, so I don't exactly know what the deal is. deal is with this. I got the information on the tobacco from somebody else who did a review. So I believe that that is correct, because they do have a Facebook, a Facebook page. And I remember somebody saying something about it being a Dominican Puro. I'm not sure, but I think it probably would have would be smoking up a little bit more if the wind wasn't blowing. Draws a little tight, but it's not horrible. I've had a lot worse. Right now, it's a pretty strong cigar. Like I said, it has a little bit of a bitter edge to it. Does seem to be opening up a little bit though, so that's, I guess that's good, huh? Just kind of keeping my eyes around. I have no idea what it is around here. It's like a medical complex over here, and a Federico's eating place over there, McDonald's right over there. Verizon Wireless right over here. Honestly, don't go to this Verizon Wireless. I've been there, it blows. Not that you know where I am, but... And not Verizon Wireless, in my opinion, but that store, really horrible. Well... It has opened up, which that's nice. But though I do still have that, it's like a edge. I'll tell you what, that guy's motorcycle's loud. Like a real kind of bitterness to my tongue right here. That I'm not a big fan of. I don't know what that is. It's not a real spice, really. My cup's all the way down here. I don't have any. Like there's an edge here. Maybe I could try. Hi. Ooh, barely. Let's see if that stays. I feel like I really got a good, what do you want to call it? Good, sweetness on that. I'm going to pause for a few minutes. I'm going to see if I maybe just shoot the area that I'm in and see how that works out. See if I turn the camera around. Criminy God. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, yeah, I guess. I can't flip the camera back around, so we'll just do it this way. Only paused it for like a second, so... Figured if I paused it, it might let me wrap that bitch around again, but it doesn't. It's burning okay for being in the wind and everything, all that crap. I guess since I have absolutely no information, I tend to get a little, I wish that they would put something out there, let you know a little bit about the actual cigar, what's going on with it. I know a ton of billions of people just buy other cigars and smoke and they don't give a shit, but I do. I care about what goes into the process and all that. A little weird. But I know, so that's all right. Hopefully the wind isn't destroying my beautiful voice. It's got some really almost kind of a greenish, dark, grassy taste. The little review that I saw that it's, you know, Dominican all the way through, which I believe is a she that wrote it, and she actually said something about it being kind of grassy, earthy, or whatever, and that's a very good description, because that's exactly what comes to my mind. It's, when you taste it, that's kind of where it goes. Sorry, I get interested in some of the shit that goes on around me. But, I don't know. I'm having a hard time really getting into this baby here. Maybe it's my surroundings, huh? Definitely has a spice to it. I definitely get that on the very front part of my tongue. Interesting flavor going. It's the burn I got. It's in the wind, so it's holding up okay for that, I guess. I do. I don't know. I never like to say bad things about a cigar. And there's nothing bad about it, but it's so far just not my favorite taste at the moment. See if I can straighten this burn out just a little bit. That really irritates me. Just that little piece. That should help a little bit. Now remember, the wind is blowing, so it's going to have a little bit to do there. I don't know. I hope everybody's doing well. It's, I don't know what day it is. Saturday, March the 8th. We got, what's that coming up? St. Paddy's Day coming up in a little less than 10 days, right? It's another reason for America to get drunk. That and Cinco de Mayo, we seem to, make up holidays to drink. So, that's a shocker, huh? I I've never really celebrated St. Paddy's Day too much. Maybe because I'm boring, that could be part of it. And then the other part is, I've never been a really heavy drinker. I like wine and stuff, so that's another part. And the only thing I ever did, I actually, was with my mom. She took me, this is when I was a kid, okay? Took me to a parade and to see the, this was in Colorado, and at that time, this is a while back, and the, so the city still is growing, not huge, and the parade was pretty lame. The dangerous streets of Phoenix. Yeah. There are accidents around this corner often, so I hope I don't want anything like that to happen though, so it's, I'm going to scratch that and say no. Trying to think if there's any been any kind of real cool. One uncool thing is the that Malaysian, I believe it's a Malaysian Airlines that disappeared. Over 200 people in it. I don't know. Just thoughts are always with the people that go through that and everything else, so hopefully you were able to hear me. That thing was all the way down underneath my shirt. I don't have a huge camera crew, any incredible lighting. I don't take this lighting with me. This is from this little strip mall or whatever the hell it is. I'm gonna tell you about this. So far in this cigar, I'm giving it a meh. If you see it, and it's not gonna burn your pocket, you want to give it a try, give it a try. It's okay. I'll put a link to the other Arson cigar that I did underneath this video somewhere, at least on YouTube. Well, actually, YouTube, Vimeo, it'll be there. My site, I probably won't have a link to it. I'm still working on getting my videos, all of them, on the site, which is a wee bit of a chore. I should have started doing that about 100 video episodes ago, huh? Trying to keep this lit. Still, is it very, definitely has bitterness to it, so it's, keep in mind the wind is blowing. Think of anything more huge to say, I'm probably going to give this one a goodbye. Not the cigar, I'll finish the cigar up, but as far as here, I don't seem to be very mouthy today, huh? But I just kind of wanted to get out and smoke a cigar, and see if I could enjoy a cigar. But this, honestly, it's not really enjoying it very much. I'm really not. It's, and I guarantee you there will be people that probably love this one. It's, like I said, it's got a bit of the spice of bitterness or whatever on the tongue. I think some people like that. A little bit stronger, I guess, maybe cigar, but I don't know. The tea kind of pairs with it decently because it settles a little bit there. I don't know. It's a... It's not bad. It's just not my very favorite. And there it has gone out. So anyway, I'm trying to think. Some kids running around out there. Just wanted to make sure people weren't coming to kill me. I had a raccoon once, right? No. Okay. Wow. Yeah. It's definitely got a different flavor. Almost tasted. Almost like when you lick an envelope sometimes, and a certain taste, that's kind of that taste right there. Yeah, it's, I'm gonna tell you, if you, honestly, you gotta try it for yourself. Like I say, I wouldn't. If you like more to the mild type cigars, that kind of thing, I honestly think they should have probably taken a little bit more time on this one, at least for my taste. And that's just for my taste. Other people's taste may love this cigar. So if you've tried it and you really like it, let me know, you know? Let me know what you think and the reasons why you like it, that kind of thing. And that way people can at least get the full spectrum of somebody who does, somebody who doesn't. But I'm one who, I'm afraid, I just not my favorite. And that's just where that is right there. So. The fact that it keeps going out now, that's a problem too. So, anyway. I might do another review tomorrow or something as well. I'll see if I can get this one up there. And hope everybody's having a great week, great weekend, great day, whatever freaking day and time it is for you. Just keep trying to enjoy every day you can, because we're only here for so much time, and then we're done. So take care. I'll be smoking with you again very soon. And take care.